Hello everyone. Today's topic is Mendelian inheritance. Sir Gregor Johann Mendel is father of genetics. He was an Austrian monk who performed his experiments in the kitchen garden of the monastery in which he lived. He started his experiments in 1856, published them in 1865, and died in 1884. His work did not receive any recognition. His work was rediscovered in the year 1900 by three scientists separately. They were Hugo de Veres, Correns, and Cheshamar. Mendel used garden pea, that is Pisum sativum, belonging to family Fabaceae, as the plant for his experiments. The seven characters which Mendel used were flower color, flower position, seed color, seed shape, pod color, and stem length. These seven characters that Mendel took were actually present in four chromosomes. They were chromosome number 1, 4, 5, and 7. Before we go to details, let's study some terms. Gene. Gene is a part of DNA responsible for a character. Alleles are the term used for genes. Alleles means different alternatives of a gene. Like the gene for stem length has two alternatives, tall and dwarf. So tall and dwarf are two alleles of the gene for the height of the plant. Similarly, green and yellow are the two alleles of the pod color. Inflated and constricted are the two alleles of pod shape. Round and wrinkled are the two alleles of seed shape. Yellow and green are the two alleles of seed color. Axial and terminal are the two alleles of flower position. Purple and white are the two alleles of flower color. Genotype is the sum total of all genes present in an organism. Or you can say it is the genetic constitution of an organism. Phenotype is the physical appearance of an organism. The phenotype depends on the genotype. Homozygous. Now, as we all are diploid, that is, we have two sets of chromosomes. For every character, we have two genes present on the homologous chromosomes. Now, when the two genes of a character, carry the same allele, then they are said to be homozygous for that character. We also use the term pure for homozygous. While heterozygous means the two genes of a character have different alleles of the character, then they are said to be heterozygous for that character. And the term used for heterozygous is hybrid. The monohybrid cross done by Mendel was by taking the height of the plant. He crossed a pure tall plant with a pure dwarf plant. He found that in the F1 generation, or the first filial generation, all the plants produced were tall. When the F1 generation is self-fertilized, means F1 tall is crossed with F1 tall, he got the ratio 3 tall and 1 dwarf in the F2 generation. After coming across the dwarf character in the F2 generation, Mendel concluded that in the F1 tall, along with the tall character, the dwarf character is also present. Of the two, only one expresses itself. The one which expresses is dominant and the other one is recessive. This came to be known as law of dominance. And he even said that gametes are not responsible for a character, but these gametes have certain factors that are responsible for the character. These Mendelian factors are now known as genes.
He then self-fertilized the F2 generation. That is the 3 tall and 1 dwarf that he got in the F2 generation. He saw that of the 3 talls, 1 tall upon self-fertilization produced all tall offsprings, which means this tall is pure. The other 2 tall again gave the ratio 3 tall, 1 dwarf, which showed that these 2 talls are hybrid. While 1 dwarf upon self-fertilization produced all dwarf offsprings, which showed that this 2 is pure. This showed that the 3:1 ratio is actually 1:2:1. 1 pure tall, 2 hybrid tall, and 1 pure dwarf. After which Mendel gave the law of segregation. He showed that when pure tall, represented at capital T, and pure dwarf, represented in small t, taken as parents, are crossed, in the F1 generation, we get tall. Law of segregation states that in a heterozygous organism, the dominant and the recessive gene, the dominant and the recessive allele will stay together throughout the life without mixing with each other. During gamete formation, they will separate from each other and enter separate gametes. Gametes will always be pure for a character. That is why this law is also referred as purity of gametes. Now, when we self-fertilize the F1 generation, these are the gametes of one parent, these are the gametes of the other parent. When these 2 T, capital T, are crossed, we get pure tall, capital T with small t, hybrid tall, small t with capital T, hybrid tall, small t with small t, pure dwarf. This showed that the phenotypic ratio is 3:1, that is 3 tall and 1 dwarf, while the genotypic ratio is 1:2:1, 1 pure tall, 2 hybrid tall, and 1 pure dwarf.
The dihybrid cross done by Mendel was by taking the color and the shape of seeds. He crossed yellow round seeds with green and wrinkled seeds. Yellow round is dominant over green and wrinkled. These are the parental generations which are always taken as pure, while these are the gametes. When yellow round is crossed with green and wrinkled, in the F1 generation, all the offsprings produced were yellow round. When the F1 generation is self-fertilized, we got the ratio 9:3:3:1. 9 were yellow round, 3 were yellow wrinkled, 3 were green round, and 1 was green and wrinkled. After which he gave the law of independent assortment. This law states that in a heterozygous organism, when 2 or more characters are taken, during gamete formation, member of each pair will separate from each other and they will form all possible combinations in the gamete. Dominant Y will separate from recessive Y, while dominant R will separate from recessive R and they will form all possible combinations in the gamete. To find out the number of gametes formed, we use the formula 2 to the power n, where n represents number of characters in heterozygous condition. Remember, number of characters in heterozygous condition. So in this case, 2 to the power n is actually 2 to the power 3. That means 8 types of gametes will be formed, since there are 3 characters in heterozygous condition. Come back to the dihybrid cross, where yellow round is crossed with green and wrinkled. In the F1 generation, all are yellow round. Now, when the yellow round is self-fertilized, according to the law of independent assortment, these are the gametes of one parent, while these are the gametes of the other parent. In this Punnett square, we'll see that the bigger triangle, 9 of which are yellow round, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In the smaller triangle, 3 are yellow wrinkled. In this triangle, 3 are green and round, while the one left behind is green and wrinkled. So, the phenotypic ratio is 9:3:3:1. Let's come to the genotypic ratio. The genotypic ratio in case of a dihybrid cross in the F2 generation will be 1:1:2:2:2:4:2:2:1:1. Means there are 4 ones, 4 twos, and 1 4. Now all the ones have both genes in homozygous condition. Means they will be either this way, this way, this way, or this way. In this Punnett square, we can find that this diagonal has both the genes in homozygous condition and they are one each. Where the condition is two, one gene is homozygous and one gene is heterozygous. Means it will be this way or this way or this way or this way. These two are same, these two are same, these two are same, and these two are same. Where the condition is 4, both are heterozygous. So this way, the genotypic ratio can be remembered. This diagonal has both the genes in heterozygous condition. By this genotypic ratio, we can easily find out the ratio of offsprings in the F2 generation. Like this is the question, find out the ratio of these offsprings. Both are homozygous, means one, this condition. One homozygous, other heterozygous, this condition. Both heterozygous, four, this condition. One homozygous, one heterozygous, this condition. One homozygous, one heterozygous, this condition. Both homozygous. So the ratio is 1:2:4:2:2:1. Now finally, here we can see that the monohybrid phenotypic ratio is 3:1 and the genotypic ratio is 1:2:1, while the dihybrid phenotypic ratio for each gene is 3:1:3:1, which becomes 9:3:3:1. Similarly, for each gene, the genotypic ratio is 1:2:1, 1:2:1, which finally comes this way, the one we have just done. In case of trihybrid cross, you can take 3:1:3:1:3:1 or 9:3:3:1:3:1. That will be 27:9:9:3:9:3:1. Now the same question. Find the ratio of the offsprings in the F2 generation, which we have just done. Both homozygous 1, one homozygous, one heterozygous 2, both heterozygous 4, one homozygous, one heterozygous 2, one homozygous, one heterozygous 2, both homozygous 1. Now the other way to do this is by separating them. Always remember, the monohybrid genotypic ratio is 1:2:1, means one homozygous, two heterozygous, and one homozygous. Or this is 1/4, half, and 1/4. So this can be applied here. One is homozygous, the other is homozygous. We have separated them. Heterozygous 2, homozygous 1, heterozygous 2, heterozygous 2, homozygous 1, heterozygous 2, homozygous 1, heterozygous 2, homozygous 1, homozygous 1, means it finally comes to the same ratio, 1:2:4:2:2:1.
Thank you for watching. Please do like, share, and subscribe.